What's up, peers, and welcome to the World Crypto Network, here continuing the reading of the Bitcoin Optech newsletter, today number 17, on October 16th, 2018. This week's newsletter briefly describes a proposal for splicing Lightning Network payment channels, links to videos and transcripts of talks from the Edge Dev++ training session, and summarizes some transcripts made during last week's CoreDev.tech event. Action item, none this week. News. Proposals for the Lightning Network payment channel splicing. Splicing is an idea for allowing users to either add or remove funds from an existing payment channel without the delay of closing and reopening a completely new channel. Rusty Rossell posted a technical proposal for allowing a single splice at a time, although he noted that the protocol is complex. René Picard describes an alternative that would likely be easier to implement and reason about, which could require more on-chain transactions. It was suggested that the simpler but more expensive solution could be version 1, and the more complex but less expensive solution would be version 2. EdgeDev++ talks are published, a two-day series of presentations from leading Bitcoin contributors aimed at developers has been published as videos and transcripts. The talks cover the full range of topics from introductory to advanced. Three talks may be especially interesting to Optech members. 1. Exchange Security by Warren Togami describes the cause behind several notable major thefts from Bitcoin and altcoin exchanges, and lists a number of techniques businesses can use to reduce their risk of loss. Wallet Security, Key Management, and Hardware Security Modules by Brian Bishop suggests method for decreasing the risk that private keys will be stolen or misused. Handling Reorgs and Forks by Brian Bishop describes how to secure your transaction against changes in the Bitcoin blockchain or consensus rules, including suggestions on for how to test your system. CoreDev.tech is an invite-only event for well-known contributors to Bitcoin infrastructure projects such as Bitcoin Core and the Lightning Network. Discussions are not recorded, but Brian Bishop, the fastest typer in Bitcoin, helpfully writes rough and non-authoritative transcripts of some of the discussions during the events. The following short summaries are based on some of the transcripts for the event in Tokyo last week. Bitcoin Optech is introduced and briefly discussed, followed by discussions of common problem Bitcoin usings businesses encounter when using Bitcoin Core and other open source infrastructure project. Using UTXO accumulators to reduce data storage requirements. Trash Dryja describes work he has been doing on UTXO accumulators that are similar in function to those described in last week's newsletter, but which have a different construction based on hashes. He further describes how they could be combined with something like CoreFields UTXO hashset, UHO, ID for full nodes to store hashes of UTXOs instead of full UTXOs in order to significantly reduce the amount of storage prune full nodes would use without necessarily requiring any changes to the consensus rules. Script descriptors and descript. The backwards compatible way wallets such as Bitcoin Core default for watching for transaction outputs, paying them, is ambiguous, inflexible, and scales badly. Output script descriptors are a simple language for describing scripts to the wallet that makes it easier for the wallet to handle many normal cases, including imports of hierarchical deterministic extended private and public keys. Somewhat related to Descript, a language that uses a subset of the full Bitcoin script language to make it easy to construct some simple policies. And I quote, "We have a Descript complier that takes something we're calling a policy language and or threshold, public key, hash lock, or time lock, together with probabilities for each or to tell whether it is a 50-50 chance or whether one side of the or is more likely than the right. And it will find the optimal script in this subset of scripts that we have defined. For example, it could allow you to do something like a multisig that after some time degrades into a weaker multisig, like a 2 out of 3, but after a year, I can spend it with just one of those keys. Notable code changes. Notable code changes this week in Bitcoin Core, LND, and C Lightning. A LND code change, the abandon channel RPC method, only available in the developer debug mode, now provides additional information when users tell their node to abandon a payment channel, a method that can cause monetary loss if used carelessly. The additional information is enough to allow either restarting an open payment channel later or to provide that the program had enough information to make additional commitments to a now closed payment channel. And a C Lightning commit. This provides a larger number of fixes and safety-related improvements on how hash time lock contracts are stored in the database. Peers, subscribe to the Bitcoin Optech newsletter, a wealth of information, and I thank, of course, all the contributors and especially Brian Bishop for providing the very, very well done transcript of the CoreDev meeting. Thank you very much and see you on the next show. Bye-bye.